Welcome. This is the Hearthstone Arena Let's Play. It is just me. If you don't like me, I'm sorry. My name is William. I drafted this little arena deck here. I think it is okay. Could be better. Got a Lightning Bolt. It's pretty cool. An axe. On a creeper. Knife Juggler. Three hexes, which could be great or terrible. So, these are all the cards. I got in Alakir, the Wind Lord. He's pretty cool, he's a legendary card. And the curve, not that great. Or it's okay. And, let's go. Woo! I guess I'll have some background on myself. I've been playing Hearthstone for roughly maybe a month and a half. On and off. I was originally playing it on my laptop, but then my laptop died, and Best Buy took it and broke my heart. And then I played on the iPad for a while, and I got a lot of progress on the iPad, and I didn't really want to switch back over to the laptop. But oh, we got our first game. But I switched over to the laptop again in recent times. Oh, it's a little loud. Don't pick that up, microphone. Alright, so for those, I imagine most people that are watching this probably play Hearthstone, or at least have an interest in it. So usually, when you get your opening hand, you want to have a good curve of mana. So for example, I can play this on turn 2, I can play this on turn 3, let's hopefully get something for turn 4. Oh, turn 4. Looky there. This is the Yeti, a very solid 4-cost creature. He's pretty cool. Look, he's got little horns. You think you're cool, huh? What should I do? I could play the Knife Juggler, but he'll probably kill it instantly. Oh well. Would be a fair trade. I think I will probably Feral Spirit. Oh no. A secret. Those who don't know, secrets activate only on the opponent's turn, so he's played it. It could be a mixture of things, and it will now only activate because it is his turn. So, I think I'll play Feral Spirit, which will give me two guys. And they're going to get this little... Hopefully I get lucky here. That's pretty good. That I don't really care about. So, in the game, it used to be that secrets would activate on anyone's turn, and people would really take advantage of that mechanic. There's a lot of interesting things you could do. But, I guess I probably shouldn't expect too many people who don't know how to play to watch this. I know the two other Lemons, the two other players on the channel, have not played Hearthstone. So I might just explain a few things. Oh, I hate that guy. Just so they can have an understanding of what's going on. So, what is my best bet here? What should I do? I think I will just go with the safer play. I'll coin out the Shattered Sun Cleric. I'll go for the face right now. There are mainly two styles. There's the aggressive arena style where you just try to rush down your opponent. There's more of a control style where you try to control the board and kill everything he puts down. And I usually play a bit more of a control style. Aggression is not really my thing in this game. Which might surprise the other Lemons. I take a calmer approach. But this guy... He's a water elemental. He's really good. I don't want to use that here. No. So, on the shaman, I'm going to roll for a spell damage totem so I can kill that frost elemental. Yes. It's pretty good for me. The thing is, I do float 2 mana this turn. I will not have a way to spend it, but that's okay. I think I can live with that. So see, instead of just hitting his face and trying to rush him down as quickly as I can, I'm gonna get rid of his guys and leave me in a good position for next turn. So I got my Alec here. Usually in the arena when someone gets a legendary, it's always like, oh, he's gonna win 12 wins. Oh, that's bad. It's not that bad. It's my best bet here. I'm gonna play the tiger. But there are a couple bad legendaries, and if your deck is not just solid all around, you know, probably not gonna do that well. Oof. How do I handle this guy? That's not a bad answer. I think I will do that. I will freeze you, sir. I could fork lightning. And I could trade the tiger into the war golem, but I think I want to keep my mana open next turn for Alec here. So this is overload, if you do not know. Overload takes 2 mana next turn. So next turn I only have 6 instead of 8. I think I will win next turn, though. Oh, maybe not. I will get close to winning. What are you doing? No, what are you doing? Don't do what you're doing. That's right. Play smart, sir. Alright, so that getting frozen's bad. I can't even kill the war golem with Alec here now. I could Doomhammer, I guess. I think my best bet actually might be to bring this back stealthed. Yeah. So, it'll be stealthed now, we can't target it next turn. It keeps it safe. And I'll set up for the kill on next turn. Unless he could freeze everything somehow. The mages can do that. They can freeze things. Like he just did before with Frostbolt. He froze my tiger. There's very little he can do though. I can't kill him. That's one thing he can do. That's a thing. Okay. What do I get? Could be interesting. So I really want to kill this. It's a 7 attack. I'm thinking, what is my best bet to do that? I don't want a super overload next turn, but I think I might have to. Of course, I could Alec here and bring him down to 4. He has Wind Fury, he can attack twice. Okay. Alright, I think this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna kill this guy. Instantly get my tiger back. I'm gonna play the hammer. And I'm really gonna hope that he cannot do a bunch of damage to me next turn. Because I am in a good position here to win. So I have Alec here, I have the hammer. I have this good tiger. Oh, he's a good look at him. He looks cuddly. With those fangs that are... It's like the size of, like, kitchen knives. Oh, no. What's he doing? He's really going all out here. I guess that's it. I win. Woo. Yeah. Oh, come on, you took my win away. Whatever. Well played. So, woo, 1-1. 1-0. I was going to say 1-1. That would be worse than what I'm doing. Look at that key. It's so pretty. Actually, it's kind of. It's okay. So, all right, round two. And that was. So that was. It was a good first game. I'm really glad I didn't get crushed, embarrassingly. That would have been bad. Yeah. I'm gonna take a sip of water here. You know, water is very important. Most people do not drink enough water. I try to drink at least 100 ounces a day. You know, I'm like a bigger guy. I'm like close to 5'11". You know, so I'm supposed to drink a bit more, but yeah, you know, it's healthy. It's good for you. Drink water. I support water drinking. One of the big weaknesses in this deck is I did not get a lot of fours. And four cards that cost four mana are important, I think. Oh, come on, guy. Come on. Come on. Tickle. Come on. Oh. Come on. Pick your card. Pick it. Okay. Oh, he got rid of three cards. His hand must have really sucked. Okay. So I guess depending, I have two turn two options. I can play the creeper. It's pretty good. It's a spider that summons 2/1/1 spiders. So even if you do kill it, it's kind of like, oh well. So I think because he didn't play anything, I'll play the spider. If he played something with 2 health, I'd probably play the axe just to kill it. Get some board control going on. So what is he going to do? What are you going to do, Gul'dan? That's your name, right? Gul'dan? Gul'dan? I'm going to say hello. Hello. Greetings, friend. You are featured in this video. Ja Gator. Ja man, Ja Gator. Ja. I'm sorry. My Jamaican accent is terrible. Okay. What do I want to do here? I think I'm going to X this. I only have 2 mana next turn. But I'll have to live with that. I guess I could summon a totem. Good old totem. Totems. I think the shaman hero ability is one of my favorites. There's 4 totems, if you don't know. There's healing, taunt. There's a 1/1 totem, which just has 1 attack and 1 health. And I like the totems. Forked Lightning would only let me have 3 mana again next turn, but I don't really have a whole lot I can play. I kind of want to play the Forked Lightning just to try and keep control here a little. Oh, well, Forked Lightning. I should have totem first. I could have gotten spell damage. Okay, well I didn't, so it doesn't matter. But yeah, so you can get, there's 4, people will say it's a little RNG, you know, because sometimes people are really banking on getting that spell damage or the taunt to win the game. But I think it's a very interesting... I hate that thing. It's a very interesting mechanic. Should I lightning bolt this stupid gorilla? I really probably shouldn't. It will gain 1 health every turn, though, very annoyingly. This stupid imp. I have no way to get rid of the imp. I have no area of effect damage. I have no way to just damage everything because it has stealth and I cannot attack it. So yay. Well, I got a Fitbit for my birthday. My birthday was this month, November, when I'm recording this. My good friend and recording partner David got me a Fitbit for my birthday. His health is something important. And I like to keep track of how much I walk, and it has some other features, like keeps you track of your sleep. You can see your sleep pattern, how restless you are. So, it's a pretty cool little thing. I'm a fan. I like the Fitbit. Oh, God. What do I value more? I definitely value, yeah. Okay, do that. I really used a Forked Lightning now. Why did I? I wasted it. Damn it. You know, I think... what do I want to do? Alright, I will freeze the Yeti. Hey, look, this little healing totem. It's going to heal my spider back up to 1/2. That value. Alright, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? I'm going to play with the map. I'm going to light a fire. Change the color of this thing. Come on. So some big games coming out. We talked about this a little bit in one of our other Let's Plays we recorded recently. But I've been playing Dragon Age, and Dragon Age is really fun. I'm enjoying Dragon Age. I do think it suffers from almost having too much to do. Like, there's so many side quests everywhere, you feel like you can't really do them all. Oh, this hand is not great. Do I have to give Wind Fury to the spider? I think I might have to. No. Oh, that's a bad idea. Why would I do that? I could copy the Yeti. I can get a 4/7. She's not really playing much. Think I'll do that. And Ancestral Spirit. Yeah, I'll wait till next turn. I'll see what he does. I'll totem. Hopefully, I get the taunt here so I can keep. Crap. Oh well. I'd like to keep the Yeti safe. Right now, I got a good setup. I mean, he could wreck me here, but he does have that imp. I hate this thing so much. I mean, it's kind of, it's not that bad. It's just annoying. So I think this Yeti here is gonna get some value from me right now. No, don't attack my Yeti. Why'd you do that? Ooh. Okay, so I will give my Yeti Wind Fury. And then I'll make it so that he's resummoned when he dies. And I'm gonna get two kills here. I'm gonna get 2-for-1 with this Yeti. And it's gonna come back. It's just gonna be like Super Yeti. And I kinda wanna kill that Yeti. I wanna kill his. Do I want a lightning bolt here? Yeah. That thing is basically all he has. He's gonna have this egg. As long as we can't activate the egg, I'm fine. I have a good board. I have Alakir. And I can Alakir reincarnate for quite the turn. That would be 12 damage. Let's do some series of bursts there. I do not like the Windspeaker. I mean, sure, some people, I think, like Wind Fury, but I'm not one of them. But it did help me there, so maybe I shouldn't be such a gentle. I'm sorry, Windspeaker. Good job. I thumbsed him up, but you can't see that. Oh, if he got this thing out of stealth, I would be so happy. Stupid egg. Or not. So that was pretty good there. What he just did. It's not good for me. Oh, now I get the stupid unbound elemental. All right. So I think the best play is probably to hex this. No, I cannot Alakir here and do that. So I guess I'm gonna hex you. Totem. Totem. Spell damage. Is there a reason not to hold on to the unbound elemental? I'll play it. Maybe I'll get scared that I have like two lightning storms or something. Ugh. This stress game is stressful. I feel like I have not played it that well. But I'm in the lead. I am in the lead. So, who knows? Oh, he's tapping. Shouldn't tap. I got Alakir. So I normally play Shaman a lot. And I don't have Alakir as a card, and this is the first time I've ever used him. I do not know. I'm pretty sure that if I drop Alakir, attack, and then use Reincarnate to bring him back, he can attack again. I'm not sure. It might be really important here to kill him, because I have 6 damage on the board, and Alakir plus Reincarnate would be enough to win. That would be 18. Oh, I no, stop, bad. Well, at least I can still set up a good position to win. Oh, I hate that thing too. What can I do here? I think maybe I want to get rid of the Demolisher, so. Maybe I should not have done that. Alright. If you're curious, Alec here says like swatting insects. I do not know what he said for a while. Oh, why'd I do that? I was gonna read. Oops. Well, let's hope he can't kill it. Because that was quite the misplay on my part. At least he's getting to the territory where he can't tap anymore. His health is getting really low. I mean, if he did it once, that would be dangerous. I guess if he could do it if he had like a taunt. Oh, why'd I do that? Oh, no, stop. You're killing my dreams right now. Oh, okay, that's fine. Okay, so I have lethal here. Do-do-do. Do-do-do. Reincarnate. Do-do-do. Up. Up. There we go. Woo. 2-0. I'm not that great at Arena. I think my best run is 9. No, I haven't been playing that long. I got one deck where I was pretty sure I would get to 12 wins. I did not. But I did have some tough competition when you get up to like 9 wins. Alright, let's keep going. I know this game is really popular on Twitch. I don't know if I know it does well on YouTube. There's some big Hearthstone players, but it's mainly a Twitch game. Or not mainly, but it is popular on Twitch. I'm gonna drink some water. Some life-saving water. Precious resource. When I first this game was first announced, I thought it was stupid. I was like, Blizzard's making a card game? Really? But I must say, it is quite a bit better than I expected. I enjoy it. I mean, I played WoW a tiny bit. I got a character to like level 60, and I was just like, eh, this is boring. But I wasn't playing it with other people, really. I was just like questing, trying to level up. So I'm sure that's a big part of why I didn't enjoy it that much. I played a lot of Diablo 3. That game is very fun. I played some of the expansion. I played it on the Xbox originally, and then I played some on PC. Oh, the egg. Oh, I hate you, egg. I don't really have. This is not a good starting hand. That's okay. I got the 1/1 totem. I got the best totem. I mean, not the best, but I like the 1/1 totem. It's good for trading early on. I don't really like it later on. No, don't kill my totem. It's precious. Damn it. Coin out the Yeti here. Actually, no. I'll play the Unbound. With the Forked Lightning in my hand, I could theoretically buff it up, I guess. But with the stupid egg there, there's not much I can do. I can always Shattered Sun this guy up. You start it from the bottom, he's gonna be there. So I got the best chair in the world just today. Well, I put it together, I got it yesterday, and it's so comfortable. I have like some minor back problems, so comfortable chairs are very nice. It is like so great. It can like go back, can, like go up. And nothing is more exciting in life than a comfortable chair. Except maybe like everything. You know, so Smash Brothers just came out. It's been pretty fun. We've been playing it, the Lemon Crew, and I enjoy it. I won't say it's better than I expected, but I feel like I didn't think there'd be that much of a difference between the 3DS and the Wii U version. So I have really been enjoying the Wii U version. Okay, so the dream here. I don't want to do this. I want. Kill this. Okay, I'm gonna play Knife Jaw. Okay. The dream would be to kill this. I cannot kill this and play the Knife Juggler and kill this. Maybe for right now I just throw down the Yeti. There's nothing I can do. All right, I'm gonna take the 1 in 3 chance that I can kill this. Because if I kill this, it's worth it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Damn it. That's still not bad. He will be pan. He will really want to kill the knife juggler. Oh. Unfortunately, his two guys will trade very well with my guys. But I will have the Unbound left. Maybe that was a mistake. I probably should not have done that. Oh well. I don't know. He's had a pretty decent start. He had the Worgen. Oh no. What are you doing? Ugh. You're killing me, guy. Ugh. Alright, so maybe. Jesus, okay. This is bad. I don't want to do this. Just drop the Yeti. Yeah, I gotta just drop the Yeti. Oh, I should not have traded there like that, or I should not have given him the opportunity to trade like that. Probably should have played that turn 3. Was it turn 3 differently? Turn 4, whatever. Whatever, still come back. I'll call it a comeback. I have a decent hand right now. Well, the wind speaker's not that helpful currently, but it could be. Oh, please don't kill. Don't kill my Yeti. Come on, it's a beautiful thing. Oh. You're killing me, guy. The Doomhammer is not bad here. But it's not gonna really do much. I think the better play is probably. I think I'll Feral Spirit Totem. And potentially play this next turn. The healing totem is pretty good here. Yes, but I do like the shaman totems. They, I think they make the class a little more fun. You get, with the, like. Oh, God. Oh, you're killing me. Stop. So I think now I pretty much have to Doom Hammer. Forked Lightning is still not that great here. With Doom Hammer, I can kill this, but I have to take 8 damage. It's probably. I could Dwarf. Destroy a minion and return it to life with full health. So I could reincarnate this, but that's not worth it either. I think I'm just gonna. And a Dark Iron Dwarf and kill the Bloodsail Raider. So we'll just kill it anyway. So, at least I have the. Well, we're relatively equal right now. Oh, that's not good. He is now ahead, I think. He will lose this turn. Alright, I think I have to Doomhammer here. Kill this guy. Oh no, this is bad. Okay. I think I just have to try and rush him down. His health is relatively low. And his board is anything he plays unless there's charge, it will be stuck. Let's just hope he doesn't have anything too crazy. I mean, if you play something big, I can hex it at least. but I have no minions in my hand. This is not that great. I don't think this deck is that great, so its weaknesses are showing here. Its lack of fours in the mid game. Or a good four draws. I mean, I got the Yeti. I got the best one I have, I think. I haven't got anything to combo with the Windspeaker. And I don't have like a Flame Tongue Totem to buff these guys up either. Come on, guy. I'll got all day. This freaking egg has been sitting here for like all game, just taunting me. Oh, I hate this guy now. Oh. Ugh. That's not that bad. Probably. You know, the chance I hit this, I'm screwed. I think I have to do it though. I could just play the War Golem. I think I'll just play the War Golem. And I'll kill off his two guys. I think I'm in an okay position here now. I just have to hope he has no burst damage in his hand. Or not enough. I mean, I'm at 13. There's not. Unless he can, like, super combo me, I think I'm okay. Oh! Damn it. Alright, Alec here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. There's a 1 in 17 chance, so not even 10%. Like 5%. A little better than 5, like maybe 6. Me's be good at math. Put out the catapult. Okay, I think I basically need to kill him this turn. Oh, okay. Alakir's pretty good here. Oh, that doesn't really help. I think I have to take the chance on the forked lightning. Just don't hit this. God. Taunt. I think there's nothing I can do now. The best I can do is like hex my own thing and make him attack it. I guess I do that. I can survive. Oh, no, he has. No, that doesn't even win. Well played. Well played. I think that I had that one big mess up. I think that probably cost me the game. Ugh. My poor key. It was a bronze key. Now it's going to be like a dirt key. Alas, we keep on fighting. Actually, I think I'll break it here. Thank you, everyone, for watching. There goes my 12-0.